Now, the 1994 Endless Mountains Festival of the Arts proudly presents the premiere night of Meredith Wilson's The Music Man.
Next station stop.
You're crazy with the heat. Credit is no good for an ocean salesman.
Board, all aboard.
Why not? What's the matter with the credit?
It's old-fashioned. Charlie, you're an anvil salesman. Your firm give credit?
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
River City next.
Cash for the merchandise. Cash for the button hooks.
Cash for the cotton goods.
goods. Cash for the hard goods.
Cash for the soft goods. Cash for the fancy goods.
Cash for the piggins and the noggins and the perkins.
Cash for the hogshead cask and demijohn. Cash for the crackers and the pickles and the flypaper.
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
What do you talk?
You can talk, you can talk, you can bicker, you can talk. You can bicker, 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 you can talk, you can talk, you can talk, 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 talk. Bicker, 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 you can talk all you want about it different than it was.
No, it ain't, no, it ain't, but you gotta know the territory.
Why, it's a Model T. Ford made the trouble, made the people wanna go, wanna get, up and go. 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 22, 23 miles to the county seat.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Who's gonna patronize a little bitty 2x4 kind of store anymore?
What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
Not the Model T at all. Take a gander at the store, at the modern store, at the present day store, at the present day modern departmentalized grocery store.
What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
Where do you get it?
You can talk, you can bicker, you can talk, you can bicker, you can talk, 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 bicker, 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 you can talk all you want about it's different than it was.
No, it ain't, but you gotta know the territory.
Why, it's a you need a biscuit made the trouble. You need to put the crackers in a package, the you need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package made the cracker barrel obsolete, obsolete.
Obsolete, obsolete, obsolete.
Cracker barrel went out the window with the mail pouch cup plug chawing by the stove. Changed the approach of the travel-end salesman, made it pretty hard.
No, it didn't, no, it didn't, but you gotta know the territory.
Gone, gone.
Gone with the hogshead cask and demijohn. Gone with the sugar barrel, pickle barrel, milk pan. Gone with the tub and the pail and the tears.
Ever met a fella by the name of Hill?
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 No!
Just a minute, just a minute, just a minute.
Never heard of any salesman Hill.
Now he doesn't know the territory.
Doesn't know the territory.
What's the fella's line?
Never worries about his line.
Never worries about his line.
Or the Cracker Barrel being obsolete, or the you need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package, or the Model T Ford.
Just a minute, just a minute, just a minute.
Never worries about his line.
Never worries about his line.
Or a doggone thing. He's just a bang beat, bell ringing, big hull, great go, neck or nothing, rip roaring every time a bullseye salesman. That's Professor Harold. Harold Hill, Harold Hill.
Tell us, what's his line? What's his line?
He's a fake and he doesn't know the territory.
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
He's a music man.
He's a what? He's a what?
He's a music man and he sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums and the big brass bass, big brass bass. And the piccolo uniforms too, with the shiny gold braid on the coat and the bigger red stripe running.
Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones. No, sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, and here and there a Jew's harp.
No, the fella sells bands, boys' bands. And I don't know how he does it, but he lives like a king. And he dallies, and he gathers, and he plucks, and he shines. And when the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When the man dances, certainly, boys. What else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory.
Crossed the state line into Iowa, River City, population 2,212. Cigarettes illegal in this state. Board.
All right, if you're all through, I'll tell you about Professor Harold Hill.
You really know Harold Hill?
Never met him before in my life, but I can tell you this much. He's given each and every one of us a black eye. After he's worked the town over, the next salesman to arrive gets automatically tarred and feathered and rowed out to the city limits on a rail. Oh, you think that's funny, huh? Well, wait till it happens to you. Your hair never grows back.
But why should he be rode out of town on a rail?
Because in order to sell band instruments and uniforms and instruction booklets, he has to guarantee to teach these kids to play.
Well?
And to form them into a band with himself as the leader.
Well, what's the matter with that?
He don't know one note from another. That's what's wrong with that. He don't know a bass drum from a pipe organ. Boy, when I get my hands on that swindling two-bit thimble rigger, I'm gonna squeal on him so loud.
Boy, Charlie, you're mad. I sure would like to be around when you catch up with that fella.
Yeah, well, I won't be here in Iowa. Even the great Professor Harold Hill wouldn't try to sell these neck-bowed Hawkeyes out here.
Gentlemen, you intrigue me. I think I'll have to give Iowa a try.
Don't believe my choice in me.
Good morning, Mayor Shin.
It is, if you want to go around your drawers all day.
And there I was in the Madison Hospital, and nobody come to see me. Cousin Will never come, Aunt Bertha never come.
Your Aunt Bertha's dead.
Well, she wouldn't have come anyway.
Mr. Squires, I'm interested in a rig for Sunday, if you could accommodate me.
Well then, I suggest you ought to see the man in charge of hiring rigs. Who is late as usual?
Hey, Gregory!
Marcellus!
What in the world?
Professor Hill's the name. Harold Hill.
But Greg, what are you doing here? Why didn't you tell me you were coming?
Well, I didn't know I was myself. Besides, how would I know you'd end up in a little tank town like this? You're a pretty big slicker when you were in business with me.
Too many close shaves the way you were. Besides, I got a nice, comfortable girl. Ethel Toffelmeyer, boss's niece.
Gone legitimate, huh? I knew you'd turn to no good.
What's the new pitch? You're not back in the band business. I thought you were in steam automobiles.
Oh, I was.
What happened?
Somebody actually invented one.
No.
So give me the lowdown here, Mars.
Oh, you won't get anywhere in the band business with these stubborn Iowans. Besides, they got a stuck-up music teacher who'll expose you before you get your grip unpacked.
Male or female?
Music teacher? She's the librarian. Female.
Perfect. That's just what I wanted to hear. If she walks by, point her out to me.
I will. How are you going to start the pitch?
Same old way. First, I got to keep that music teacher off balance. My next step's going to be to get your town out of the serious trouble it's in.
River City isn't in any trouble.
Then I'll have to create some. Got to create a desperate need for a boys' band. You remember the pitch. Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Except the billiard parlor just got in a new pool table.
Never had a pool table before?
Nope, only billiards.
That'll do. See you later, Mars. And don't forget, music teacher.
Music teacher.
Are you Mr. Dunlop?
Yep.
Well, either you're closing your eyes to a situation you do not wish to acknowledge, or you're not aware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a billiard player. Certainly mighty proud to say I'm always mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help you cultivate horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Did you ever take and try to give yourself an ironclad lead from a three-rail billiard shot? But just as I say it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a balk-line game, I say that any boob can take and shove a ball in a pocket. I call that sloth and the first big step on the road to the depths of degradation. I say first, medicinal wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pinchback suit. Listening to some big out-of-town Jasper here and telling about horse race gambling. Not a wholesome trotting race, no, but a race where they sit right down on a horse. Like to see some stuck-up jockey boy sitting on Dan Patch. Make your blood boil, well, I should say. Friends, let me tell you what I mean. Yeah, one, two, three, four, five, six. Pockets in the table, pockets in the market difference. Between a gentleman and a bum with a capital B, and that rhymes with peanuts, stands for pool. And all week long, your River City youth will be frittering away. I say your young men will be frittering. Frittering away there. Noontime, suppertime, chore time too. Get the ball in the pocket, never mind getting dandelions pulled to the screen door, passing to the beefsteak pounder. Never mind pumping any water till your parents are caught with a cistern empty on a Saturday night, and that's trouble. Yes, we got lots and lots of trouble. Talking about the kids in the Knickerbocker, short tail young ones, peeking in a pool hall window after school. You got trouble, folks, right here in River City. With a capital T and it rhymes with P and it stands for pool. Now, I know all you folks are the right kind of parents. I'm going to be perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on while they're loafing around that hall? They're trying out Bebos, trying out Cubans, trying out tailor-mades like cigarette fiends, and bragging all about how they're gonna cover up a telltale breath with sensail. One fine night, they leave the pool hall, heading for the dance at the Armory. Libertine men and scarlet women and ragtime, shameless music, it'll grab your sons and your daughters by the arms of the jungle, animal instinct, masteria. Friends, the idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble! Right here in River City, with a capital T and that rhymes with P and that stands for pool. We surely got trouble. Right here in River City, you gotta figure out a way to keep the young ones moral after school. Mothers of River City, heed that warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The moment your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee?
Trouble!
Are there nicotine stains on his index finger?
Trouble.
A dime novel hidden in the corn crib?
Trouble.
Is he starting to memorize jokes out of Captain Billy's whiz bang?
Trouble.
Are certain words starting to creep into his conversation? Words like swell and
trouble.
So's your old man.
Trouble.
Well, if so, my friends, you got trouble right here in River City. With a capital T and it rhymes with P and that stands for pool. We surely got trouble.
We surely got trouble
right here in River City.
Right here.
Remember the Maine, Plymouth Rock and the Golden Rule.
Our children's children gonna have trouble.
Oh, I got trouble. I got terrible, terrible trouble. That game of 15 numbered balls of devil's tool.
With a T,
and a rhyme with P,
and
I stand for pool.
short while.
Good.
That you, daughter?
Yes, Mama. Keep on, Amaryllis. I'll be there in a minute. Mama. Fine, dear. Now do your exercises.
Yes, Mom.
I don't remember the library being open the last 4th of July.
It was, Mama, all evening. Mama, a man with a suitcase has been following me all over town.
Oh, who?
I never saw him before.
Did he say anything?
He tried.
Did you say anything?
Mama, of course not. Now don't dawdle, Amaryllis. Sol, do, la, re, ti, mi. A little slower, and please keep your fingers curved as high and nice as you possibly can. Don't get faster, dear.
If you don't mind me saying so, it wouldn't have hurt you to have found out what the gentleman wanted.
I know what the gentleman wanted.
What, dear?
You'll find it in Balzac.
Excuse me for living, but I've never read it.
Neither has anyone else in this town.
There you go again with that same old comment about the low mentality of River City people and taking it all too much to heart.
Mama, as long as the Madison Public Library's been entrusted to me for the purpose of improving River City's cultural level, I can't help my concern that the ladies of River City keep ignoring all my counsel and advice.
But darling, when a woman has a husband and you've got none, why should she take advice from you? Even if you can't quote Balzac and Shakespeare and all them other highfalutin Greeks.
Mama, if you don't mind my saying so, you have a bad habit of changing every subject.
No, I haven't changed the subject. I was talking about that stranger.
What a stranger?
With the suitcase who may be your very last chance.
Mama, do you think I'd allow a common measure? No, really, Mama, I have my standards where men are concerned and I have no intention.
I know all about your standards, and if you don't mind my saying so, there's not a man alive who could hope to measure up to the blend of Paul Bunyan, St. Patrick, Noah Webster. You can count it for yourself. Out of your Irish imagination, your Iowa stubbornness, and your library full of books.
Well, if that isn't the best I've ever heard.
Thank you. Can I have a drink, please?
May I have a drink, please?
May I have a drink, please?
You may.
Winthrop, it's after dark. Is that a way to walk into the house?
Hello.
That won't do. I'll have a kiss from my boy. The lady over there is your sister, young man.
Hello, Winthrop.
Where's your manners, Winthrop?
I'm having a party on Saturday. Will you please come? I would especially like it very much if you'd come. Winthrop?
Well, Winthrop, Amaryllis asked you to her party. Are you going or aren't you?
No.
No what?
No, thank you.
You know the little girl's name.
He won't say Amaryllis because of the S because of his lisp. He's ashamed.
We all know about his lisp, Amaryllis. Well, Winthrop?
I bet he won't say it.
No, thank you, Amaryllis.
Amaryllis, Amaryllis. He's crying. Why does he get so mad at people? Just because he lisps?
It's not only because he lisps, Amaryllis. That's just part of it.
Well, what's the other part?
Never mind, dear. It's just that he never talks very much.
Not even to you or your mother?
No. We all have to be a little patient.
I'm patient. even though he doesn't ever talk to me, but I do him every night. I say goodnight to him on the evening star. You have to do it the very second you see it, too, or it doesn't count. Good night, my Winthrop. Good night. Sleep tight.
There, there, Amaryllis. Don't cry. You have lots of time. If not Winthrop, there'll be someone else.
Never. I'll end up an old maid like you. I'm sorry, Miss Marion. Can I play my crosshand piece?
May I play my crosshand piece?
May I play my crosshand piece?
You may.
You see, without a sweetheart, you have no one to say goodnight to on the evening star.
I know. But for now, just say goodnight, my someone. You can fill in the name when the right person comes along.
All right. It's better than nothing.
Yes, it is. Now you can play your crosshand piece.
Now I may play my crosshand piece.
To me, I wish they'd met.
I'm sure we're all grateful to my wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, for leading us in the fine singing. And to J.C. Squires for his fine stereotician slides. And to Ethel Toffelmeyer, our fine player, piano player, piano. Yes. As Mayor of River City, I want to welcome all of you River Cityans to the 4th of July exercises held indoors here in the Madison Gymnasium on account of the weather. 47 years... Four score and 7 years ago, the members of the school board will now present a patriotic tableau. The members of the school board will not present a patriotic tableau, some disagreement over costumes, I suppose. Instead, the Wauton Yi girls of the local wigwam of Hiawatha will now present a spectacle, my wife. In which my wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, will take a leading part. Will take place, pervading the rain stops by 9:30. It'll be held out in the Madison Picnic Park in the far meadow across the creek from the pest house.
How can it be raining? Didn't the Gazette predict fair?
Sure did, Ewart. That's why we all prepared for a storm.
The Gazette's accurate most of the time, and you know it.
You wouldn't get far in the banking business being accurate most of the time.
Number H late again tonight.
Well, I make her early.
Oh, no. She's late, all right.
She's right on time. What's the matter with your watch?
Nothing. Hey, let me have your eyes on the most. Will you school board members please stop bickering in public?
Hello in the world.
Never mind!
47 years
We're
ago.
Near the pool table in town.
Now, wait a minute.
Will you allow me to get on with the exercises?
We don't want no more exercise till we get this pool table matter set off.
Let's protect our children.
Yeah.
Resist sin and corruption.
Yeah, yeah.
Smite that devil and keep our young boys pure. Friends, may I have your attention, please? Attention, please. I can deal with your troubled friends with a wave of my hand, this very hand. Please observe me if you will. I'm Professor Harold Hill, and I'm here to organize a River City Boys Band. Simpsons, how could any pool table ever hope to compete with a gold trombone? Ra, 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 da, 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 da. Remember, my friends, what a handful of trumpet players did to the famous fabled walls of Jericho. Hope billion poly walls come tumbling down. Oh, band will do it, my friends. Oh, yes, I say a boys band. Do you hear me? I say River City's got to have a boys band, and I mean she needs it today. Well, Professor Harold Hill's on hand. River City's gonna have a boys band. Sure as the Lord made little green apples, and that band's gonna be in uniform. Johnny, Willie, Teddy, Fred, and they'll see the crashing of cymbals, and they'll hear the thunder of rolling drums and the shimmer of trumpets. Ta-ta-da! And they'll feel something akin to the electric thrill I once enjoyed when Gilmore, Liberati, Pat Conway, W.C. Handy, the great creator, and John Philip Sousa all came to town on the very same historic day. 76 trombones led the big parade. Well, 110 cornets close at hand. They were followed by rows and rows of the finest virtuosos, the cream of every famous band. 76 trombones caught the morning sun. Each bassoon having its big fat say. There were 50 mounted cannon in the battery, thundering, thundering louder than before. Cornets of every size and trumpeters who'd improvise a full octave higher than the score.
Thank you, Professor. Have to make an example of him. Ringleader, you know. What he does, the gang does.
Jimmy Clyde, let me go.
You wild kid, you? Hanging around after my oldest girl? His father's one of them day laborers south of town. You wild kid, you? Tagging down Main Street after my oldest girl last Sunday?
I wasn't either tagging.
Don't you contradict me.
We's just walking together. Jimmy Clyde.
I'm gonna warn you. Watch your phraseology. I'm gonna warn you once more. You stay away from my oldest girl, or you'll hear from me till who laid the rails. Hill, I'll talk to you Monday morning about this band thing over to City Hall, 10 o'clock sharp. Men, I want that man's credentials.
Constable, I'll be responsible for the boy.
You don't know this kid. He's tough, and he's got his gang waiting outside.
Oh, I'll be careful. Tommy, I'd like to talk to you about the band.
Aw, oh, gee, Professor, that's for the little kids.
Well, I'm not talking about you playing in the band. You're mechanically minded, aren't you? Ever do anything with perpetual motion?
Nearly had it a couple times.
You did? You're my man. Do you realize nobody's ever invented a music holder for a marching piccolo player?
No place to hang the music.
Well, Geely Cly, wonder where I could get some wire from.
Look in your cellar. That's where people keep wire. Oh, Tommy.
Yes, sir.
Now, Constable, I'll show you how to break up a gang. Oh, young lady. Oh, miss. What's your name?
Zanita. I didn't have any idea you was beckoning to me. But...
Zanita, do you know Tommy Gelis?
Well, I...
Tommy, this is Zanita. Why don't you escort the young lady home?
Only accepting I'm not going home. I have to go to the library. God.
Well then, escort the young lady home by way of the library. Here. By way of the candy kitchen.
Yes, sir. Do I have to?
You have to.
Oh, yes, sir.
God.
Professor, you're a pretty bright young fella. You made a couple of mistakes, though.
Oh?
The mayor happens to own the billiard parlor and that new pool table.
What was my other mistake?
That's Zanita. That's the mayor's oldest girl.
Just a minute, Professor Hill. We need to have your credentials. We're the school board.
Academic credentials.
Nothing of the sort. Oh, we need papers and letters.
Yeah.
Make him put up a bond.
What am I hearing? Say, ice cream.
Ice cream, but I don't sing, young man.
No. Well then, talk slow. Ice cream.
Ice cream.
Talk slower. Ice cream.
Ice cream.
See, singing is only sustained talking. Now you, sir.
Ice cream.
And now you.
Ice cream.
And now you, sir.
Ice cream.
Ladies, from now on, you'll never see one of these men without the other three.
Oh, Professor, you're wrong. Why, they've hated each other for 15 years.
Ice cream.
How can there be
any sin insincere? Where is the good in goodbye in goodbye? Your apprehensions confused. Shines above. How can there be any sin insincere? Aren't we sincere?
wonderful caramels over to the hotel.
Mr. Hill.
Oh, please, please, Professor Hill.
Professor of what? At what college do they give you a degree in annoying women on the street like a Saturday night rowdy at a public dance hall?
Oh, I wouldn't know about that. I'm a conservatory man myself. Gary, Indiana, gold medal class of Op 5.
Even should that happen to be true, does that give you the right to follow me around wherever I go? And another thing, Mr. Hill, I'm not so easily mesmerized and hoodwinked as some people in this town, and I think it only fair to warn you that I have a whole shelf full of reference books in there that may give me some very interesting information about you.
Hey, Gregory!
Marcellus! Don't call me Greg.
How'd you make out with that music teacher?
Oh, scrumptious. Ate right out of my hand.
She did. Boy, you kind of swathed tonight. For a minute there, even I thought you knew something about leading a band. Just like when you used to imitate that band concert fella back in Joplin.
Ah, kid stuff. You just keep your eyes on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? I thought it took only 10 days to get the band instruments.
Well, it still does. But it takes 4 weeks for the uniforms.
Oh, no, Greg. You haven't added uniforms.
Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But, Greg, you can't pass yourself off as a music professor. Not for any 4 weeks.
Nice.
But you don't know one note from another.
Got a revolutionary new method called the think system. You don't bother with notes.
But in 4 weeks, people want to start to hear music. You will have to lead a band.
In 4 weeks, when the uniforms arrive, they forget everything else. At least long enough for me to collect my money and leave. Oh, this is a refined operation, son. And I got it timed right down to the last wave of the brakeman's hand on the last train out of town. And now, Mr. Washburn, if you'll excuse me.
Gonna you lie yourself up a little canoodling, huh?
Well.
Hey, let me fix you up with Apple's sister. Lovely girl. Teaches Sunday school.
No wide-eyed, eager, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of girl. Spins webs no spider ever. Now listen, boy. A girl who trades on all that purity merely wants to trade my independence for her security. The only affirmative she will file, the first two marching down the aisle. No golden, glorious, gleaming, pristine goddess. No, sir, or no Diana do I play pawn. I can tell you that right now. I snarl, I hiss. How can ignorance be compared to bliss? I flinch, I shy. When the last with a delicate air walks by, I smile, I grin. When the girl with a touch of sin walks in, the center but buys a girl for me. No bright-eyed, blushing, breathless baby doll baby. No, sir, that kind of child ties knots. No sailor ever knew. I prefer to take a chance on a more adult romance. No, do you miss who keeps resisting all the time she keeps insisting? No wide-eyed, wholesome, innocent female. No, sir, why she's a fisherman, I'm the fish, you see. I flinch, I shy. When a lass with a delicate air walks by, I smile, I grin. When the gal with a touch of sin walks in, I hope, I pray for Hester to win just one more hay. The Santa but wise girl's a girl for me. The Santa but wise girl for me.
Oh, Professor Hill, we're all agog, simply agog.
On the cue, babe! Everyone is so excited about the band.
I'm Ethel Toffelmeyer, the pianola girl. And this is Mrs. Squire. And Mrs. Hicks. And of course, you know Eulalie McKechnie Shin, our mayor's wife. Oh, isn't it exciting, Eulalie?
Oh, I couldn't say. I could not say. I could not say it this time. My husband will wish to investigate, I'm sure. And naturally, I'm reticent. Oh, yes, I'm reticent.
Well, yes, of course, Mrs. Shin, I understand. But you see, part of my musical plans include a committee on the dance and... No, wait. Do that again, Missy Chin. The way you lifted your foot just now.
Oh, well, I have a bunion there. That bothers me.
What grace. What natural flow of rhythm and movement.
Oh, Mr. Hill.
You simply must accept the chairmanship for the ladies' auxiliary dance. Mustn't she, ladies?
Oh, yes, you ladies, please do.
Why, every move you make, Mrs. Shin, bespeaks Del's art. Will you? Will you? Say yes, Mrs. Shin.
You love him, a technician. Well, I am dancing.
Then you accept?
Yes, indeed. And I would like to say...
Thank you. Thank you. Now, the young lady who plays the piano, Marion Prue, I believe? Well, after all, she is a librarian.
Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, tick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, tick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, tick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, tick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little
more. Her kind of woman doesn't belong on any committee. Of course, I should tell you this, but she advocates dirty books.
A dirty book? Chaucer.
Chores to a man who never had a friend in this town till she came here. Old Miser Madison.
Miser Madison? Madison Gymnasium? Madison Picnic Park? Madison Hospital? That Miser Madison?
Exactly! Who do you think he was?
Well, I should say, show-off. Gave the town the library too, didn't he?
That's just it. When he died, he left the library building to the city. But he left all the books to her.
She was seen going and coming from his place.
Oh, yes, oh, yes. That woman made brazen old dirt with a kick-kick guarantee. She had a golden thing to dry and a silver voice to the company. Just knock her down and you reveal a look of that is called hysteria, where a woman's heart should be.
Take me a minute. Good night, ladies.
Good night, ladies. Good night, ladies. Good night, ladies. We're going to leave you now. Farewell, ladies. Farewell, ladies.
I know everything, and it doesn't make any difference.
What are you talking about?
You were probably very young, and one can make a mistake.
What?
No apologies. No explanations, please. Only be in town for a short while, and quite frankly, the sight of a wiser girl for me.
Would you please make your selection and leave?
Oh, I have.
Well, what would you like to take out?
The librarian.
Quiet.
You're not listening, Marion. Marion. Look. Marbles. 6 dealies, 8 aggies, a dozen peewees, and one big glassy with an American flag in the middle. I think I'll drop them.
No!
Madam Librarian. What can I do, my dear, to catch your ear? I love you, man.
Madam Librarian, Marion, Helen, help us if the library caught on fire and the volunteer hose brigade men had to whisper the news to Marion. Madam Librarian, oh, what can I do, my dear, to make it clear? I need you badly, badly, Madam Librarian, Marion. If I stumble and I busted my watch in my collar, I could lie on your floor unnoticed till my body had turned to carrion. Madam Librarian. Now in the moonlight, a man can sing it. In the moonlight, and a fella would know that his darling had heard every word of his song. With the moonlight helping along, when I try in here to tell you, dear, I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian, Marion. It's a long lost cause I can never win. All the civilized world accepts as unforgivable sin. Any talking out loud with that librarian, such as Madam Librarian. when I try in here to tell you, dear, I love you madly, 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 librarian. Marianne, it's a long lost cause I can never win. All the civilized world accepts this unforgivable sin. Any talking out loud with that librarian, such as Marianne.
The ladies' dance committee meets Tuesday nights at the high school.
Marshmallow?
Well, Tommy, we've had a pretty good morning. 11 sales out of 12 tries. Tell you what, it's almost noon. Why don't you go home and get something to eat? I'll try a couple by myself.
Goodbye, Professor.
Hey, thanks, Tommy.
Just a minute there. Are you soliciting? You haven't got a license.
Why, no, Marishin. I collect buttons. This particular specimen has an unusual quality.
Flattery
that
will not avail you. Soliciting statutory in this county.
Malfeasance without a permit. Why haven't you been over to City Hall with your papers?
Why, I must have missed you. Mr. Mayor.
What? What?
That spread of the little finger. That's hereditary, you know.
It is? What does that mean?
Well, it means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate the spit valve on a B-flat flugelhorn.
Is that good?
Good. Why, it means America has finally produced an artist who can flugel the minute waltz in 50 seconds.
How can I get me one of them horns?
Sign right here. That'll be $17 import fee.
Just think, I could have missed this whole... I haven't got a son! You're unscrupulous, flew by night. You're unflipulous! You'll be down to City Hall with your papers at 3 o'clock.
You mean this afternoon?
I couldn't make myself any plainer if I was a Quaker on his day off.
Why, Mrs. Peru, do you realize you have the same facial characteristics as a cornet virtuoso?
I don't know if I understand you entirely, Professor.
Well, if your son has that same firm chin and those splendid cheek muscles, not that he could ever be really great, by George.
Oh, is that so? And in the name of St. Bridget, why not?
Oh, you see, all the really great cornet players were Irish. O'Clark, O'Mendez, O'Klein.
But, Professor, we are Irish.
No. No. Well, that clinches it. Your son was born to play the cornet. Sign here. That'll be $7. Nothing more due until the first installment payable at the opening of band practice. Thank you. Thank you. Fine, now. And of course, I'll need the boy's measurements for his uniform.
His uniform?
Why, hello, son. Of course, his uniform. Which gives him 4 weeks to enjoy, to anticipate, to imagine at no cost whatever. Never allow the demands of tomorrow to interfere with the joys and excitement of today.
Would I have a...
A stripe? Why, certainly, my boy. A wide red stripe down both sides. What do you think of that?
You'll have to excuse Winthrop, Professor. We can't get him to say more than 3 words a day, even to us. And if you can get him to play in the band, you'll have St. Michael's own way with you. But if anybody can do it, I'll bet you can. Out of a crowd, I'll pick you for hod-carrying, clay-pipe-smoking, shamrock-wearing, harp-playing, mavourneen-pinching, terrace hall mister, singing Irishman. Be gobbin', be jabbers. Where you from, me by?
Gary, Indiana.
I knew it. Where did you say?
Gary, Indiana. In fact, Gary Conservatory was my alma mater.
Was she now?
Gold medal class of odd five. Well, how to do, Miss Peru?
How to do, Mr. Hill?
Peru. I should have known. I've been trying to see you all week.
He wants to put Winthrop in the band.
We're not interested, Mama.
But Marion, he might have his father's musical gift. He does have my jaw, you know.
Your husband's musical? Oh, I'd like to talk to him. I'll bet.
Do you burst into everyone's home like this, prying into personal affairs? We are not interested.
Marion!
Well, that's one for and one against. Why don't we let the boy's father decide?
The boy's father is dead. Anything else?
Oh, I'm sorry. But that's all the more reason why your brother should have something like this.
My brother is a 10-year-old problem child who can't understand why his father has been taken away from him. Would you care to explain it to him? He's been brooding about it for 2 years. And as for your musical tricks, why don't you go into business with some nice carnival man who sells gold-painted watches and glass diamond rings?
Musical tricks? Why, Miss Peru, I get a feeling she likes the idea. Well, a bit hesitant, perhaps, but I like that in a woman. Just keep me alive till next week and I'll be back.
Oh, Professor Hill, about the boy's measurements. I make all his clothes. Sleeve 21, waist 18, crotch 14.
Thank you. Now, I really must get back to the hotel.
Oh, Professor, I hope you'll forgive Marion. She's really not as bad as she
could
talk to be.
Not to worry, Miss Peru. I'm sure that at heart she's as lovely as yourself. Good day, Widow Peru.
Has he gone?
He has. And I hope not forever. Darling, don't you ever think about your future? Gary, Indiana, conservation class of '05. Now, darling.
Now, Mama, surely a girl's future doesn't depend on encouraging every fast-talking, self-centered, woman-chasing, traveling man who comes along. And the fact that he claims his commodity is music does not, in this particular case, impress me.
All right, darling, all right. But it's a well-known principle, if you keep the flint in one drawer and the steel in another, you'll never strike much of a fire.
Mama! Winthrop, I know you're there. Winthrop, please go to the library and ask Miss Grubb for the book I set aside. It's the Indiana State Educational Journal, 1890 to 1910. It's a large brown volume with black corners.
Do I have to?
You won't have to say anything, dear. I've written it all down. Thank you.
Now what are you up to? Why do you need library books at this hour of the night?
I have a feeling that this Indiana Journal will help me poke some rather large holes in the professor's claims.
Well, I give up. At your age, if you don't mind me asking, what kind of white knight do you expect to come riding along anyway?
Well, I'm not waiting for Luther Griner, who backs me up against the ancient history shelves every time he comes into the library.
He does!
Or Ed Gamage, and that buggy of his with the removable back seat. But I'm not waiting for a knight in shining armor, either.
My white knight, not a Lancelot, nor an angel with wings, just someone to love me, who is not ashamed of a few. Say if it only knew all. Please, dear Venus, show me now. All I want is a plain man. All I want is a modest man, a quiet a stray.
like him to be. Himself, and more interested in us than in me. And if occasionally he'd ponder what makes Shakespeare and Beethoven great, him I could love till I die. Him I could love till I die. My white knight, not a Lancelot, nor an angel with wings.
Morning of July 4th, 19 and 12. And now look, my wife's off dancing at any and all hours instead of at home.
But George,
the school board singing up street and down alley. My oldest girl's bowling about with some wild kid. And my business has fallen off so far I can't find the balance sheet.
Mayor Shin, I found some interesting information in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
His who?
His university.
I know all about that. In fact, that's the only thing I can ever get out of him. Gary Conservatory, class of 05.
Yes, but if you'll just take time to read a little bit, you won't have to look any further. It's right here on page...
Papa! The Wells Fargo wagon's coming up.
The Wells Fargo
wagon? A likely story at this time of the day? Nonsense. The Wells Fargo wagon?
It could be the band instrument.
The band instruments?
Grapefruit from Grandma.
Bandage!
Here you are, Winthrop.
My coronet keeping, Professor.
Kids! You will each receive individual instruction in due course. In the meantime, stay off the streets, get familiar with your instruments, and think the minuet in G.
La-dee-da-dee-da.
Round one for you, Mr. Hill, but I better hear some tooting out of those horns in pretty short order, or I'll see you in front of the grand jury over at the county seat. Now, Miss Marion, about that book.
Come, George, have it mute.
You watch your phraseology, young woman. I'll be along in a minute. I gotta get something from the library.
Ladies' dance committee meets Tuesday nights at the high school.
It's you in the sunrise, it's you in my car.
It's you all the way into town.
It's your sweet hello, dear, that sets me up. And it's your got to go, dear, that gets me down.
Will have my head.
Mr. Washburn, we are entitled to 5 more minutes!
Well, if you think you can hold these kids back, go right ahead.
Start her up, Mr. Washburn. Wait to see the new steps Professor Hill taught us.
All right, what will it be?
The Shapoopy. Yay!
Now the woman who kissed in a vapor's bathe is usually a hussy. And woman who kissed in second time out is an she's a girl you
his face to cook in the smoker. Ted Roper never gets on the way to supper.
Behind your back.
Why, you?
We'd rather do it in front of your back, but...
Do what? Never mind.
Well, Zanita's scared of you, but I'm not. I should think you'd hate to have your own daughter scared of you, Jilly Clyde.
You watch your phraseology. You stay away from my oldest daughter, or I'll horsewhip you till hell won't have it again.
Now, George!
Not a poop out of you, madam.
I think he means pee.
Yes. Now get out of this public building.
I got as much right in this public building as anybody.
How do you get any rights around here? Aiding and abetting the swindling activities of that spellbinding symbol salesman? You know what I see written all over you? Reform school. Now get out, you wild kid! Get out!
Papa, please! It's kind of lads like you make blood in the marketplace. Be gone!
You watch your phraseology! You go on home, young woman! Eulalie?
Yes, George!
You tend to your dance!
My dance is the
last... I'll handle Zanita! Hanging around with wild kids from the wrong side of town?
Mr. Mayor, if I could just make you understand.
Well, you can't. And by the way, thanks for nothing. I read that book you gave me cover to cover for a whole week and didn't find a thing.
Mr. Mayor, if you please.
I'll settle your hash as soon as I get the premises off my oldest daughter. Yes.
All right, but in the meantime, I want you to know I'm vouching for Tommy Gelis. That boy's got the confidence of every kid in town. You'll be standing in line waiting to shake his hand by the time our boys play his first band concert.
By the time your boys play their first band concert, the individual members will have to gather in wheelchairs from the broken legs they'll have them tripping over their beards. And another thing, my fine, feathered, young, fine... Never mind! Oliver! J.C.! Owen! Dort! I want that man's references and I want him tonight! Don't let him out of your sight! He's slippier than a Mississippi sturgeon!
You mean... You want us to get his credentials?
Get his papers or get him in jail! I couldn't make myself any clearer. It was a butt hook in the well water!
Professor Hill, I think Mayor Shin behaved abominably. And I think it was wonderful of you coming to Tommy's defense.
Oh, it was nothing.
Yes, it was.
Oh, a man can't dodge the issue every time a little personal risk is involved. What did the poet say? A
coward dies 1,000 deaths, a brave man only 500. Unfortunately, the mayor was already pretty mad on account of his billiard parlor. Now, suppose a recommendation from a musical authority like yourself would help, but I couldn't ask you to do that.
Why, Professor Hill.
You would?
I'd be glad to. It's just that I wish I was a little more informed. I've been meaning to ask you about Winthrop's coronet.
His coronet, Mother Pearl Keys?
I'm sure it's fine. But you see, he never touches it. Oh, the first week or so, he made a few experimental blats, I guess you'd say.
Yes, yes, blats.
And he sings the minuet in G di da di da.
La di da di da di da di da.
But he never touches the coronet.
Well.
He says you told him it wasn't necessary. He tells me about some think system. If he thinks the minuet in G, he won't have to bother with the notes. Now, Professor.
Well, you see, Miss Mary, the think system is a revolutionary new method, I'll admit, but so was Galileo's conception of the heavens. Columbus, conception of the egg, a globe. Bach's conception of the well-tempered clavichord. Now, I cannot talk about these things in public, but if you allow me to call, when may I call?
Why, any night this week.
We've just come to tell you that your kind of woman belongs on the Del Sart Committee.
You were so dear tonight dancing the Shabooby with Professor Hill. You dance like a fairy princess with a moonbeam for your car. You had a golden shimmer in your hair and silver shoes for all to see. We know that you will soon unfold a forgiving heart.
We need to have your credentials.
We all been deputized.
Right.
Why, yes. Congratulations. You know, I've been trying to give you fellows my references and credentials all week, but you always seem to get off the subject somehow. Have just what you want up the hotel.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid I'll have to go with you.
Oh, no. Well, let me see if I got my keys. What's this? A testimonial from Madame Rini, the only female bassoon player ever to appear on the Red Pass Circuit. Her stage name, of course. Actually, she was from Moline, Lida Rose Quackenbush.
Could I see that for a minute?
Oh, who could ever forget that name, Lida Rose? Same as the old song. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose.
To get the sun back in my sky. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, about 1,000 kisses shy. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bell chime. Ding dong ding, at the least suggestion I'll pop the question. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Lida Rose, now everyone knows that I am hoping you're the same. So here is my love song, not fancy or fine. Lida Rose, oh, won't you be mine? Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose.
Dream of love, dream of them.
Stop arguing with yourself. Will you ever tell him how you feel? Won't you tell him? Ah, yes. Ah, no. Ah, fiddlesticks. Just open your mouth and let it come out.
No, Mama.
Now, nothing. If he ever comes to call again, you'll see him alone. And if you haven't the gumption to tell him how you feel...
Tell him?
Well, there's nothing wrong with a lady like him, you know.
Mama!
Winthrop, where have you been?
Fishing.
Fishing?
With Harold.
You mean Professor Hill?
Mm-hmm. And I still have some wonder.
Did you have a good time?
Scrumptious. He told me all about his hometown, Gary, Indiana. And he said he'd take me there someday. And he taught me a song with hardly any S's in it. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, let me say it once again. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, that's a town that knew me when. If you'd like to have a logical explanation, how it happened on this all can think of patience.
I'll do them, Mama.
Don't you have to get ready for the sociable?
There's time later.
Do the Shins live around here somewhere?
The Shin home is on East Elm. This is West Elm.
Oh, criminy. Say, I see you're a piano teacher here in town. You must have heard about that fella Hill forming a kids' band around here?
Yes.
Well, you don't have to worry no more. I got the goods on him in spades. Swindling two-bit thimble rigger. That's why I gotta see Shin. I'm just passing through. Number 8 only makes a 15-minute water stop. Sure wish you were 20. I'd like to concentrate 5 minutes on you, girly girl.
Who are you?
Charlie Cowell's the name. Anvil salesman. But right now, I'm out to protect the good name of the traveling fraternity from that two-bit swindler.
Mr. Cowell, I think you're making a mistake.
Mistake? My old lady's corset cover. That fella's been a raspberry seed in my wisdom tooth long enough. He spoiled Illinois for me, and he's not gonna spoil Iowa. Say, what kind of music teacher are you anyway that you didn't see through this guy? Why, he's no more a professor
than... Oh, I know all about that. Band directors are always called professor. It's a harmless deception. Why, he's a fine director.
Now, wait a minute. Fine director? Have you heard one note of music from any band?
No, but...
But nothing, girly girl. He's never formed a band in his life, and he never will.
But if you'll just listen to me for a minute...
I'd like to. I'd like to do more than that if I had the time. I sure got the inclination. But I gotta get back to the train, and I gotta leave word about the Hill with somebody at the depot. Bye, girly girl. See you next time through.
You'll never make that train at the depot. You'll have to catch it at the crossing.
No, sir. I gotta leave word with someone, and I can see you ain't the one to leave it with.
J. Just a minute, Mr. Cowell. You don't know me yet.
Is that an invitation?
No, but... I mean, I don't know you.
Yeah, I need more time anyway.
I mean, as well as I'd like to.
No trouble there, girly girl.
I've never met a man who sells anvils. That must be something, well, quite different.
Yes, sir. It takes a real salesman, I can tell you that much. Anvils have a limited appeal, you know. Oh. What am I doing? If I miss my train, I'll lose my job. And I gotta leave word to someone about Hill.
Leave word with me.
Not on your tintype. How do I know you'll deliver these letters?
Try me.
There's your train, now run for it!
Why, you double-deal little... Who do you think you're trying to protect, anyway? That fella's got a girl in every county in Illinois, and he's taking it away from every one of them. And that's 102 counties. Not counting the piano teachers he's cozied up to keep their mouths shut. Neither one of you's heard the last of me yet, girly girl.
Ding dong ding. At the least suggestion, I'll pop the question. Lila Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Good evening, Miss Mary.
Just now. Why, Professor Hill.
Well, good evening, Whittaparoo. Miss Marion.
Why don't you and Marion come up and sit? I've got some jelly on the stove.
There's no jelly on the stove, Mama.
Well, I'll put some on.
Shall we sit, as your mother said?
Well, I...
Well, you did ask me to call.
Did I? I didn't mean anything.
Oh, Miss Marion, I'm not suggesting that your invitation inferred anything but academic enlightenment, the think system. You know, I've been by your house a couple times this week to try to explain, but there always seem to be people around. Mostly ladies, I thought.
Yes, Mrs. Squires and several of the ladies.
Well, I'm glad. Wouldn't want anybody beating my time. You wouldn't. No, ma'am. Well, it's obviously not the convenient night. See you at the sociable later.
Professor Hill?
Yes?
Is it true that you've had 100... I mean, what I'm trying to say is... Is it true that you've... developed a think system?
A what? Well, think system. Well, yes. It's really quite simple. It's as easy as whistling. Nobody has to tell you how to use your lips to whistle. You only gotta think a tune to have it come out clearly right here. Try this yourself before you ask any questions.
I'll take your word.
Could we sit down?
Are all music teachers as dense as I am?
All music teachers?
I dare say you've met dozens. Maybe even 100.
Well, I...
Have they all been as fascinated as I have with the think system?
Some more. Some less. You know, one young lady thought up the same system before I came to her town. She showed me a few refinements.
I see.
Did I say something wrong?
Oh, please don't let me keep you, Professor Hill. I'm sure you have many more important things to do than explain the think system to me.
Can't think of one.
And I must be very dull company for a man of your experience.
Now, Miss Marion, where'd you get an idea like that?
One hears rumors of traveling salesmen.
Well, Miss Marion, you shouldn't believe everything you hear. After all, one hears rumors about librarians.
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie.
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison, father's best friend. no matter what they say. He left me an assured job so that Mother and Winthrop and I would have some security. Surely you don't believe.
Well, of course not. But why do you think people start those rumors?
Narrow-mindedness. Jealousy. Jealousy mostly, I suppose.
Exactly. And jealousy mostly starts rumors about traveling salesmen. What have you heard?
Oh, nothing about you personally. Just generally.
What'd you hear generally?
Just that. Well, but of course it stands to reason that disappointments and jealousy could lead to... Well, take you, for example. Your attentions to customers and music teachers might easily be misinterpreted, mightn't they? I mean, now, honestly, mightn't they?
Well,
And so you say if another salesman or somebody were jealous, why, they could be downright lies, couldn't they?
What could?
Rumors and things. It just goes to show you that you shouldn't believe everything you hear. I mean, if you just discuss things.
Now, Miss Marion, I'd be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you, but could we do it sitting down? You do sit. Your knees bend and all.
We could sit on the porch.
Or we could sit on a large hollow log over to the footbridge.
I couldn't think of it. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Just to talk?
I have to dress for the sociable.
Then meet me there in 15 minutes.
I can't. Please, some other time. Maybe tomorrow?
My dear little librarian, you pile up enough tomorrows, you're going to have nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. I don't know about you, but I'd like to make today worth remembering.
Oh, so would I.
The footbridge. 15 minutes.
15 minutes. Mama!
What?
I just told Professor Hill I'd meet him at the footbridge in 15 minutes.
Glory be and the saints be praised, it works!
What does?
The think system! I've been using it on you in the parlor!
Thank you.
Marcellus.
The uniforms have arrived. The kids are already in them. The people will be screaming for music if those kids show up at the social bowl.
Yeah.
Here's most adult. I, Tommy, collected. He's trying to keep the kids together at least, pretending to hold a practice down at the lumber yard.
All right. Get the rig.
I got it.
What time's the freight leave?
9:40 from the junction.
It's not even 8:30 yet.
Look, you want a turtle whirl around here and get yourself caught in
Don't
a bunny trap?
Don't worry, Mars. I'll meet you at the hotel in plenty of time. Oh, Miss Marion, you're late.
But you said 15 minutes.
Well, I meant you're about 26 years late. Took you all this time to get to the footbridge with the fella.
Well, if you'd like to know the truth, it was almost longer.
Oh?
Halfway here, I nearly turned back. I suppose I'm not the first to find it easier to think clearly when not under the spell of your salesmanship.
Now, Miss Marion, surely you don't think I'm trying to sell you anything?
No. You've given me something. That's why I decided to come.
I don't recall giving.
Oh, yes, you have. Something beautiful. That's why I came, and I'm glad.
Yeah.
Oh, please don't be afraid that I expect too much more. One can't expect a traveling salesman to stay put. I know there have been many ports of call, and there will be many more. But that's no reason for me not to be grateful for what you've left behind for me.
Marion, I...
There were bells on the hill, but I never heard them ringing. No, I never. Oh,
Marion, there's a lot of things you don't know about me.
Psst. Hey, Greg.
Excuse me. I'm expecting a cable from Hector Berlioz. This could be it. Now what?
Who's the salesman around here? Sounds like she's selling and you're buying.
Are you nuts? I didn't know I was going to be able to leave tonight. Had to keep her off balance, didn't I?
Well, she's so far off balance now, you can't tell her from a cat boat in a hurricane.
Listen, Buster. I've worked myself up through the ranks on this skirmish, and I'm not resigning without my commission.
But you can't get anywhere out here on the footbridge.
Here's a place over to Madison Square. Make this footbridge look like the old lady's home. Now beat it. Go get the rig. Never a peaceful moment in the music business. Now, where were we?
You were about to tell me what I don't know about you.
Yes, well, we really don't have time to get into that right now, do we?
No, we don't. Or ever, for that matter, Harold. The librarian hasn't felt much like doing research lately, but she did an awful lot when you first came here.
No? About what?
About Professor Harold Hill, Gary Conservatory, gold medal class of '05. Harold, there wasn't any Gary Conservatory in '05.
Why, there most certainly...
Because the town wasn't built till '06. See you at the sociable.
You knew all the time?
Since July 7th, 3 days after you came, I tore this page from the Indiana Journal. I originally intended to use it against you, but now I give it to you. With all my heart.
Well, if you knew, why didn't you? Why, you little... Well, 110 cornets played the air. Then I modestly took my place as one and only bass. And I hooped up and down the square.
Good night. My someone, good night, my love.
With 110 cornets right behind.
Our star is shining its brightest light.
There were horns of every shape and kind. Sweet dreams be yours, dear, if dreams there be.
Well, 110 cornets played the air.
I wish I may, and I wish I might. Now, good night. My someone, good night.
Greg, this guy's crazy. He's gone all over town spilling everything.
Missed my train, probably lost my job, but I got you now, Hill, and you're gonna pay. You'd be in the clink right now if it hadn't been for that piano teacher. I tell her all about you, and what'd she do? Lily gags me all around till I couldn't see Shin. Dried up, man-hungry ducks.
Get out of here. Get out of here or I'll kill you. You dirty mouth.
You bully? You big blow-off? I'm gonna stay in this town till you get yours up, down, two, and sideways. Why, you never even knew the territory.
Here's your stuff. The rig's in the alley. Come on, hurry up.
Appreciate it.
goats? Can't you get it through your heads you're being swindled out of your eye teeth right now, this moment?
What?
There's a burglar in the bedroom while you're fiddling in the parlor. I'm talking about Professor Harold Hill, highwayman, road agent, pickpocket.
Pickpocket?
Same thing. He's had his hands in your wallet, mister. And yours, madam. And yours, little lady, since the moment he came to this town. Why, there's more documented evidence than you'll ever have a chance to read. There isn't any band. There never has been any band. And there never will be any band. And if you don't hunt this man down now like a mad dog, there won't be any Harold Hill either, because he will be on the next train out of town.
Now, Emily!
Well, what are we waiting for?
I want my money back.
Money's back? I want it high.
After it! And bring it back to the schoolhouse! After it!
Had to talk to you.
It's all right. Don't you know that? You don't owe me a word. Not a word. Now go, please.
Greg! Greg! He's not around here anywhere! Let's find out where the crack!
Winthrop!
Oh, hold it here a minute, son.
I know you thought. Leave me go!
Not till I talk to you for a minute.
I wouldn't listen and you wouldn't tell the truth anyway.
Would two?
Would not.
Would two tell you anything you want to know?
Can you lead a band?
No.
Are you a big liar?
Yes.
Are you a dirty rotten crook?
Yes.
Leave me go, you big liar!
What's the matter? You wanted to know the truth, didn't you? I'm bigger than you, and you're gonna have to stand here and take it off, so you might as well quit wiggling. Well, there's two things you're entitled to know. One, you're a wonderful boy. I thought so from the start. That's why I wanted you to play in a band. So you quit moping around feeling sorry for yourself.
What band?
I always think there's a band.
What's the other thing I'm told to know?
Well, now that I think of it, the other thing's none of your business.
I wish you'd never come to River City.
Yeah, no, you don't, Winthrop.
Sister, you believe him?
I believe everything he ever said.
But he promised us.
I know what he promised us. And it happened, just like he said. The lights, the colors, the flags, and the symbols.
What was all that?
And the way every kid walked around here all summer and looked and acted, especially you. And the parents, too. Does Mother wish he'd never come to River City?
Well, you do, don't you?
No, Winthrop. Now go, Harold, please.
Go on, Professor. Hurry up.
I can't, Winthrop. For the first time in my life, I got my foot caught in the door. There was love all around.
but I never heard it singing. No, I never heard it at all till there was you.
I did everything in my power to prevent this dire happening from happening. Four score and 7 years ago.
What are you doing to get our money back?
Yeah! That professor collected nearly $300 for uniforms just tonight!
We haven't seen them uniforms yet!
And he's slippery, I told you!
I haven't seen a uniform
with
my voice and
fast supper. He's a kidnapper!
Yeah!
Oh, I get it.
Over score 7 years ago.
What is going on?
Wait a minute.
What?
Virtue has sway. The is cut through, Mr. Harold Hill. And there are those of you, as I have heard, who are collecting tired, nothing feathers. Yes. I will not say you nay.
Well, I should think there ought to be some of you who could forget your everlasting Iowa stubborn, chip-on-the-shoulder arrogance long enough to remember River City before Professor Harold Hill arrived. Do you remember? Well, do you? Surely some of you ought to be grateful for what he's brought to River City. And if so, I should think you'd be willing to admit it.
You're wasting a great deal of time here. If there's a person in this hall who doesn't think Hill should be tarred and feathered, let him stand up! Standing there like a crop of Sharpshire sheep. Had you forgotten the money you spent on band uniforms? Technical instruction books. Expensive band instruments. Had you forgotten that you bought it with a clear understanding and warranty that your children would be taught to play in a band? Well, where's the band? Yeah. Where's the band?
Kids. sink!
Thank you.
And the fact that he claims his commodity is music does not, in this particular case, impress me.
All right, darling, all right. But it's a well-known principle, if you keep the flint in one drawer and the steel in another, you'll never strike much of a fire.
Mama! Winthrop, Winthrop, I know you're there.
Winthrop! Winthrop!
Winthrop! Are you there? Please go to the library and ask Miss Grubb for the book I set aside. It's the Indiana State Educational Journal, 1890 to 1910. It's a large brown volume with black corners.
I don't suppose you live alone or anything.
No.
You know, I got some wonderful caramels over to the
hotel. Professor Hill.
Oh, please, please, Professor Hill.
Professor of what?
Obsolete.
Cracker Barrel went out the window with the mail pouch cup plug gone by the stove. Changed the approach of the traveling salesman. Made it pretty hard.
No, it didn't. No, it didn't. But you gotta know the territory.
Gone. Gone.
Gone with the hogshead cask and demijohn. Gone with the sugar barrel, pickle barrel, milk pan. Gone with the tub and the pail and the tears.
Ever met a fella by the name of Hill?
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 No!
Just a minute, just a minute, just a minute.
Never heard of any salesman. Hill.
No, he doesn't know the territory.
Doesn't know the territory.
What's the fella's line?
Never worries about his line.
Never worries about his line.
Whether Cracker Barrel being obsolete, or the you need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package, or the Model T Ford.
Just a minute, just a minute, just a minute.
Never worries about his line.
Never worries about his line.
Or a doggone thing. He's just a bang beat, bell ringing, big hog, break, go, neck or nothing, rip roaring every time a bullseye salesman. That's Professor Harold Hill, Harold Hill.
Tell us. Beautiful.
Harold, baby.
I don't think so.
Oak.
Leonard, she has a doctor's appointment.
Well, sometimes they don't keep them.
That's not pretty.
Yeah, and then she's going to pull them back for now. But it's like down by Longwood Gardens.
That'll look.
They are so fresh.
He's getting the town. At least he's getting the townspeople. At least we rate a little bit. He's getting the townspeople.
I don't
sit down on the show. I'm staying.
They were going to be there for the oil night. They were going to be there for certain.
I know.
I would just imagine.
I left another thing when I was putting on my hair.
Do you want a live shot of the quartet?
Just the first note on the crossover. First note on the crossover, or first phrase on the crossover.
Get it right.
Light arose, I'm home again, rose, to get the sun back in my sky. Light arose now,
and then my sky, right?
You go past our house down Mill Street. You know Mill Street? It's the only street.
Going down to the
school.
Yeah. The old school. Yeah, park at the old school. Park at the old school because our backyard goes against it.
We're taking this outside. We're going to set it up for our
heads up.
Daydream.
Push.
That's what we're
doing. Yeah. You got an awesome bite of it right on our arm. I don't know what I'm doing.
Ladies and gentlemen,